rise for the pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
All right, Ashley, can you call the roll?
Bryant? Calderon?
Here.
Murphy? Bips?
Here.
Reddicker?
Here.
Shaylee?
Here.
Saunders?
Here. All right, section three, 3.1, can I get a motion to approve the agenda for tonight?
Second.
Calderon?
Yes.
Shaylee?
Yes.
Reddicker?
Yeah.
Bips?
Yes.
Saunders?
Yes. All right, section 3.2, we actually have two items we need to vote on today. So the first is, can I get a motion to approve the closed session minutes from April 26, 2023, and June 21st, 2023?
So moved.
Second.
Shaylee?
Yes.
Reddicker?
Yep.
Bips?
Yes.
Calderon?
Yes.
Saunders?
Yes. Second, the closed session minutes from the last 6 months. So I'll need a motion to approve the board's semi-annual review of unreleased closed meeting minutes and to keep sealed the closed session minutes from the last 6 months, specifically September 28, 2022, October 26, 2022, November 30, 2022, December 21st, 2022, January 21st, 2023, February 22nd, 2023, March 9th, 2023, March 29th, 2023, and May 31st, 2023, as the need to maintain confidentiality continues to exist.
So moved. Bips?
Yes.
Reddicker?
Yes.
Calderon?
Yes.
Shaylee?
Yes.
Saunders?
Yes. All right, next, I need a motion to extend the non-disclosure of the recordings of the closed session portions of the board's meeting set forth below for the reason that the need to maintain confidentiality continues to exist. Therefore, keeping the audio recording sealed for closed session meetings recordings older than 18 months, specifically June 21st, 2021, August 25th, 2021, September 27th, 2021, October 28th, 2021, November 4th, 2021, November 22nd, 2021, and December 16th, 2021.
So moved.
Second.
Calderon?
Yes.
Bips?
Yes.
Shaylee?
Yes.
Reddicker?
Yes.
Saunders?
Yes. Section 4.1 is an opportunity for visitors to address the school board concerning any agenda topic. All right, seeing or hearing none, we'll move to section five. Section five, consent agenda items. Is there anything that someone would like to pull? Hearing none, can I get a motion to approve the consent agenda items?
So moved.
Second.
Shaylee?
Yes.
Calderon?
Yes.
Reddicker?
Yes.
Bips?
Yes.
Saunders?
Yes. All right, section six is the personnel consent agenda items. Is there anything that anyone would like to pull out from this agenda?
Yes, the administration would like to remove Josh Talley from 6.5 under transfers due to some changes in personnel staffing needs at this time.
Anyone else?
executive board of the Chatham Chamber of Commerce. That was Friday night at Sweet Corn Festival that ask happened, so we're excited that's gonna happen in the August meeting. I am now the vice president of the CACC board and the secretary of the Rocky board. I've been a member of the JCs the entire school year and commit to somewhere around 5 hours of community service with them depending on the events per month. I also sit on the Titan Field board and I worked with the Springfield Chamber of Commerce last year in a couple of events where I was a guest speaker and already have a September date in on the books to present to their leadership academy as well again. So this was a busy year. We had a lot of great things. So sometimes things happen so far back we can't remember them. But remember, we had the Today Show come visit last fall. I really did nothing to make that happen, but paved the way to make sure that we could roll out that red carpet to NBC and make sure that we shined brightly in that event. But a lot of credit goes to Caitlin and the parent who nominated us for that. We also had the governor's visit in January, which was another red carpet type event. That's kind of a once in a lifetime thing. If you think there's 800 plus school districts in the state of Illinois, they don't come around every day. So that was also the numerous recognitions that our staff and our students had this year. So many so that you know that we were staffed up on agendas trying to recognize every one at each meeting once a month, and it's astounding the accomplishments that our staff and students are doing, not only in academics and in fine arts and athletics as well as extracurriculars. So just an amazing district to be a part of. As we move forward then to just the upgrades that we made this year, and thanks to Mike who's in the audience tonight, just the things that we are working towards fixing, upgrading, and staying on top of being current. So working on a plan for that and looking forward to that as well. So we know some of those projects are very slow to happen. It was almost a year ago that we started talking about the telephone project, and hopefully it will be done in the next 2 weeks. And sometimes when we don't hear about them, we think they're not happening, but they really are behind the scenes. So just highlighting that we do still have forward progress on a lot of topics, and anyone can reach out at any time and ask me where we are on that. So, so new leadership involvement moving forward. So I sort of covered some of this already, but ROCTI, CACC, and then I just wrapped up and been sitting on a superintendent review panel for ISB literacy plan. So that was also an exciting thing. We are poised to run through our final approval of Portrait of a Graduate, Portrait of an Educator, and our school improvement plan at next school board meeting. We're just doing lots of last minute grammar, spelling, and final looks by many, many people. And I think that's how we spent most of our year, was just collaborating with every stakeholder who we could, and the number of times that we asked students for their input, parents for their input, our staff input, our community input, really taking into account all of those voices to be able to publish what I think is going to be a superior project, product, at next month's board meeting. So as we're moving forward, we also had to navigate the unexpected this year. So the tornado, the water line break, supply chain issues, but we were able to not have those hold us back, but learn from each one of those events, take information from them, and be able to move forward. So we're very glad that the tornado arrived when students were not in school, and that we only suffered minimal damage across our facilities, but we're also no questions. I just want to say congratulations on a successful first year and thank you for all of the hard work. I know you have put in countless hours on behalf of our district, and so thank you for your hard work and congratulations on
it. Thank you.
We're very, very busy.
And I mean, I think I will just say too that one of the things that we are taught when you're getting on the board is that the most important thing that you will do is hire a superintendent, right? And I think a lot of boards don't get an opportunity to do that, and we did get an opportunity to do that. And I will speak on behalf of myself, but I think the other board members agree. I think we made a tremendous hire in that, in really setting our district up for success moving forward. So, congratulations. All right, next item is 7.2, also with Dr. Lehman, Title IX updates.
This is much shorter. we emailed the federal OCR on June 30th asking for an update on our Title IX plan, and their response was that they currently do not have an update, and we are in the process of reviewing the district's last submission from November 30th, 2022. They appreciate our patience as they've had an influx of complaints, and they hope to provide us an actual update to our plan soon. So I have it on my calendar every other month to reach out to them, and that just happens to be our latest update. So eventually, I will say something other than I don't have an update.
Thank you. And that's really like information
yes.
purposes for the public, just
yes.
to know that we're staying on top
yes.
of it. It's not disappeared.
No.
We're just in a holding pattern
no.
waiting for OCR to get back.
And I will add that Caitlin and I actually participated in a superintendent's Title IX update because we were supposed to have new regulations at the end of May. The federal OCR has pushed that now to an October at least release date. This opportunity for this webinar happened. We sat through it, and it was a speculation of what they think might change, not change, or change in a major way, and that they also, and this was the National Superintendents Association is also, and their legal staff are also unsure of what is happening right now. So we will just wait till those get released.
All right, item 7.3 is the bid for the GHS restroom partition replacement project.
Yes, so as probably most of you know, the restroom partitions at the high school are, they're original, they're 21, 22 years old. They're builder's grade metal, they're pretty flimsy. And I mean, if you've been in the bathroom gym, you understand. So they're pretty flimsy, plus they're 22 years old. So we went out to bid on replacing those things with a higher density plastic product, and actually two of the men's bathrooms, boys' bathrooms have already been done, and the product is, I mean, it's a very, very nice product. They're not just going to knock it over. It's a pretty solid product. So we had three bidders, MJ Products out of St. Louis, who was actually the supplier of the materials anyway. So they came in, the low bidder, to do all the restrooms. So when I broke this thing down, I broke it down by boys and girls just so we would see the difference. And the only reason the boys are drastically lower is because we've already done two bathrooms.
Okay.
But I did want to break it down in case we didn't want to do girls' bathrooms, but did want to do boys. I didn't think that would be the case, but you know, all the options are out there. So anyway, what I'm asking for approval, board approval, and this includes the 10% contingency, I'm asking for $90,037.20.
Does anyone have any questions? Can I get a motion
So to answer your question, we will have the partitions in. There is one restroom that doesn't have partitions right now.
But when school starts, there'll be at least a partition.
Yes, there'll be two.
Stall, okay.
There'll be two stalls.
Okay.
So it's not the new, it's the old.
Correct, it's the old. But there, they are new panels that we bought to make repairs.
Sure.
And, but they are new panels, but.
Thank you.
And so just to clarify, we will have rolling restroom shut down.
Yes.
One by one, not all at one time.
Correct.
It'll be one by one as they move through them, depending on when the materials come in.
That is the point.
And so there will be some inconvenience for a couple of days per location.
If we gave them all of the work at one time, they said they could have it done in a week. So, you know, we're still talking probably 5, 6, 7 days worth of work, but they're gonna just work their way around the school.
That answers my question.
Any other? All right, can I get a motion to approve as I outlined previously?
So moved. Second.
Reddicker.
Yes.
Bibbs.
Yes.
Schraley.
Yes.
Calderon.
Yes.
Saunders.
Yes.
Sorry, that was just a lot of words, I didn't understand. All right. Section 7.4 is the GHS lighting upgrade project.
So I'm sure most of you have been involved in this at one point or another. So that entire auditorium over to high school needs to be upgraded lighting and sound. We chose to do the lighting portion first. There's no way in the world you can do all of it at one time. We chose to do the lighting first because it's a big piece. It's pretty costly, but. So basically what this is all the theater lighting. This is all the classroom, or all of the standard lighting out in the field of the auditorium, along the rows where the seats are on the ground floor, and the seats that will all be done, and the side lights on the side. Everything will be upgraded to LED lighting. New controls, new everything. Everything in that place will be new LED, up-to-date fixtures. So early on, we had some interest with, we had actually two or three different contractors that have actually made calls and asked about the project. We had a couple, I think three or four of them at the pre-bid meeting. We got one bid. The only thing I can attribute that to is this workload on their part. That's really all I can attribute to. We don't really ask that question too much, but I mean, I know it's this time of year people are busy, you know, we're stacked up with work, so I'm sure that's why we only got one bid. So basically, I'm asking for the whole project cost is $1,007,237. So what I want to, so with a 5% contingency, the architectural fees is $1,007,237. That's what I'm asking for.
Does anyone have any questions?
I guess, is there some way when you get a single bid to judge the reasonableness of it if you only have one?
The architects do that. Prior to, they kind of, well, I'm not going to say they don't know their numbers, but they kind of have an idea how the numbers are going to come in because they have all the estimating software and all that stuff. So they know, when they wrote the specs, they know exactly what's going to go in there.
So that you have an expectation about a
we do. We have what we call a budget summary. So every project that the architects have done, give me a budget summary. So you guys don't see it, but it's a budget summary. And basically it says the architect estimated this budget to be, just for example, $1.2 million. Actually, this thing was, I think we actually budgeted, I can't remember exactly what it was, but it was well over this.
I remember.
Yeah, it was well over this. We consider this a good price, actually. But yeah, we do a budget summary on all projects ahead of time, so we kind of have an idea what it should come in at. Sometimes they guess, but not often.
Thank you for that explanation.
This might be, I was
just going to say that, you know, we know that when our auditorium was built, it was state-of-the-art originally. And it was a place in which people wanted to have a lot of performances. We got a lot of outside groups that were coming in that were using it for, like, dance performances and things like that. Since then, we haven't done any kind of upgrades to it, and other schools have come along and have made pretty massive upgrades or have built their own, in which they have become more destinations for that kind of thing. Is this going to help
us as a
district to get those types of performances from outside the school district coming in?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Sorry. I mean, I'm not a performer or anything like that, but I do guarantee you, this lighting upgrade is gonna be top of the line, top of the line.
If memory serves, I think that was part of the reason this project got going in the first place.
Well, the lighting is, first of all, you can't even buy parts for lighting, and the light system that they have over there now, you can't even buy replacement parts for it. So we're piecemealing it together, some of the lights work, some don't, you know, it just, it's really, really in bad shape, so this is good, absolutely.
This might be a dumb question, but is there, what is the reason that in some projects, for example, the restroom partition had a 10% contingency, but this project has a 5% contingency, what?
I knew that was gonna get asked. So.
So maybe it's not a dumb question, if you thought of it too.
No, it's not a dumb question at all, it's not a dumb question at all, the reason that, that the restroom project is a 10% contingency is because they're drilling into unknown walls. Okay, so we don't know water lines, we don't know what's back there. So if they hit something, hit a water line, hit something back there, these contingencies are there to cover that, that's why. Everything else, we kinda know, we kinda anticipate what's gonna happen, and we know what's gonna happen because it's exposed, we can see it, can't see through the walls.
Got it, thank you.
Any other questions or comments? All right, can I get a motion to approve moving forward with the GHS lighting upgrade project by awarding the contract to Synergy Electric as presented?
Second. Fitz?
Yes.
Calder?
Yes.
Shaylee?
Yes.
Reiniger?
Yes.
Saunders?
Yes. All right, you're getting a lot of actions. Number 7 point, action item 7.5 is the bid for the GHS generator radiator replacement project.
So this project actually started last year, we identified the radiator, we were told that the radiator had a leak last year in the generator. We tracked it for like 5 weeks, we never found a leak, so we just, you know, we just quit looking at it and all that good stuff, and everything was good, our generator ran, everything was good to go, we had a power outage, generator ran for hours and hours and hours, no. Then all of a sudden, about a month and a half ago, we get a little coolant alarm. So we go look at it, sure enough, the radiator's leaking. How, I mean, it hadn't even run, so how that, I don't know. So we had the guys go over there and fill the coolant up, and ironically, yesterday, the alarm went off again. So it's a little coolant alarm. So we have to get that radiator replaced, just like a radiator in the car, you have to do it. If this thing kicks, what, right now it won't run. So until we put coolant back in again, but, so once it runs out of coolant, it's gonna lock down like an electric car would. So basically what I'm asking for is get the radiator replaced for $38,342.15 now. In addition to that, we're going to have to rent an emergency generator, a backup generator to back this one up. We lose power next school, we lose internet to the district. So I have an email out to the vendor, to the same vendor, rents these things out. I have an email out to them right now trying to get a quote for a rental generator, be a monthly charge. And I did get one when the thing failed the first time. It was roughly $10,000 to $11,000 a month for this thing. But better to have a generator than run out of power. So.
And that's during the conversion over?
Yes.
So a limited period.
Correct, yeah. No, I don't want to lose coverage on that school at all.
Yeah.
If I keep running.
How long?
The lead time, what did I put in there? I think they said the lead time was 4 to 6 weeks.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, 4 to 6 weeks lead time on the materials. Maybe it'll get here faster, maybe it's slower, I don't know. So I anticipate probably 2 months with the rent. I don't know that yet.
Yeah.
It's like you did information, I'll obviously share.
But as frequently as we have lost power
yeah.
in
August 15th at 4. The Finance Committee will meet, and our next regularly scheduled board meeting is scheduled for August 23rd at 6:30 right here in this room. And we just want to point out that there was an update to the February board meeting. The date was listed incorrectly. It has been fixed to reflect the 4th Wednesday of the month. All right, 8.2 is an opportunity for visitors to address the school board concerning any topic. Seeing none, section 9, I will move to adjourn the meeting. All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you.